is an integral part of our lives, whether for work, social commitments, or simply pleasure. A massive and growing population of young people are fueling a very active travel market in India. Social media and blogging is aiding the boom and changing the way Indians travel. Indians, particularly the middle class, are traveling more than ever. According to reports, the average Indian online traveler is taking 3 leisure and 4 business trips in a year. For domestic travel, trains are the most commonly used mode of transportation, while with budget airfares, flights are not far away. Travelers are taking over 8 billion train trips every year on the Indian Railways' expansive network of over 18,000 trains. In 2019, nearly 345 million travelers had departed via flights from Indian airports, and millions of people take intercity bus trips every single day.
$20 billion worth of travel is picked up online. India has the world's largest railway network. We have more than 23 million people who travel on trains every day. We have 400 plus airports, and I dare say in the next 5 to 10 years, it will nearly double.
By 2007, the aviation and travel boom in India was well on its way. A number of online travel companies were making traveling a cheaper and more convenient experience for all. The companies were also in between raising their rounds of funding and jostling each other for market share. In between all of this, two young men were also toying with the idea of joining the online travel revolution. Aloke Bajpai, co-founder and CEO, the risk taker, an IIT Kanpur software engineer and an MBA from INSEAD Business School. He had already spent over 4 years working in France for Amadeus, a travel technology company. And now he wanted to come back home and start something of his own.
It all started when I was just finishing my business school. This was 2005 and gotten out of INSEAD, and Rajnish and I had both worked together at Amadeus in Europe for a while. I think at that moment it was just this strong urge to go back to our country and contribute meaningfully over there, and we wanted to test our potential to the maximum, let's put it that way. So we came back to India in 2006 and started working on the idea of Ixigo together around mid-2006.
Rajnish Kumar, co-founder and CTO, the tech head. He had spent the past 6 years working in France and Spain for the same travel company. He too had the startup fever, wanting to build a company of his own. He was our Aloke's batchmate from IIT Kanpur.
We had very comfortable jobs. We were probably in one of the best places in the world. It's just that we are so bored, we didn't have enough challenges. We always had it in us to kind of do something of our own. Even when we were in the university, we had tried to do something, didn't work out, but at the back of our head, we always wanted to do something.
In 2006, Aloke and Rajnish moved into a rented flat in Gurugram and started working out of their living room to start Ixigo.
The initial routine was like we would work till like 2, 3, 4 a.m. in the morning, go back to bed, get up at 11 and come back out of the bedroom, just say good morning, eat breakfast and start again. So it went on like that for like days and weeks until we were able to build the product that we wanted to build.
6 months of working for long hours on the computers and brainstorming on whiteboards took them to the point where they were ready to expand their team.
What was interesting is that we actually managed to launch Ixigo without a lot of capital. I don't think we'd raised even $100,000 by the time we actually launched Ixigo, which was June 2007. In hindsight, we were not that planned back then. It was just about, we know what we want to build. Let's get it live as soon as we can.